B-Monster Laboratory here. Today you're going to see how to make your own matrix display using Arduino with an 8x8 MAX7219 LED dot matrix display module. This guy right here. There is a lot to love about this module. Not only do you have one 8x8 LED matrix, but you've got four matrices in one module. And another thing about it is that it's crystal clear, crisp, bright, easy to read, makes for a great scrolling marquee, signage, you can put symbols on there, you can put animation, and if this module is not big enough for you, you can chain other modules to it, making a bigger display. Let's take a look at a couple things it can do. In this video, I'll be using a breadboard. I'll be using some male-to-male and male-to-female wires. I'll be using the LG Uno, or if you have an Arduino Uno, that's fine too. You can also use the Nano or the Mega board. I'm also using a DC 5-volt power connector, which I'm really starting to like, but you can also use a breadboard power supply with 5 volts if that's available. And I'll be using the MAX7219 LED dot matrix display. This one still has plastic on it because it's brand new. And that will be it. Here's the module that I'm using. I have two of these, but I'm just going to use one for this video. And this module has four of these 8x8 LED matrix or matrices. And each matrix has 8x8 rows and columns. And these rows and columns are all wired together. And the reason they're wired together is to allow us to use fewer number of pins. And you can see here we use 16 pins, 8 on the bottom, 8 on the top. If these weren't wired together, you would need 65 pins. You would need one pin for each LED and then one pin for the anode or cathode connector. So by wiring all these together and only using 16 pins, this is a technique called multiplexing. And multiplexing is a very cool way, I think, very neat way to use LEDs, because in this technique, each column is activated for a very short period of time, a very short burst. And at the same time, the LEDs on that column are lit by addressing the corresponding rows. And it's so fast, hundreds of times a second, that the persistence of vision of the human eye can only see this as being fully lit when it's actually not. So therefore, only at most, you're going to have 8 LEDs lit at one time. So it's pretty neat. So we'll take a look at the module here. I've removed two of the matrices here, and underneath we see the MAX7219 chip. And it doesn't say it on here, but usually it'll say the name of the chip. This one is the MAX7219 chip, and under each matrix you'll see that chip. And this chip is quite capable of controlling 64 individual LEDs, which you see on the matrix here. And that also includes the ability for this chip to maintain brightness of the LEDs or to adjust brightness of the LEDs. And this particular IC communicates through SPI interface. So we only need three data pins to connect to a microcontroller. As you can see, the DIN, the CS, and the clock pin. And through these three data pins, you can connect multiple matrices, which is what they've done for this module. You can also add multiple modules using those data pins. If you do connect more than one module, this is what the pin connection will look like, and this is what the pin connection looks like when you flip the back of the module over. And I mentioned that this chip communicates through SPI interface. That is serial peripheral interface. It's commonly used to send data between microcontrollers and small peripherals such as shift registers and sensors and SD cards. And we're using it here with this module. When setting this up on your breadboard, you want it to take your VCC pin and connect it to a 5-volt power supply. If you're just using one module like I am, it's fine to operate that through your microcontroller. If you're using more than one module, you'll definitely want to go to an external power source, whether that is a plug adapter like I have or a breadboard power supply. The next pin is your ground pin. That'll go to common ground. The next pin is the DIN pin, and that will go to pin 11 on your microcontroller. The next pin on your module is the CS pin, and that will go to pin 3. And then your final pin is a clock pin, and that will go to pin 13 on your microcontroller. Well, here we go. Let's take a look at the code for the scrolling display. And you'll want to include these libraries, MD Parola and MD Max72. You can find these on GitHub. If you do a search for that on GitHub, a guy named Marco has a blog, and he posts his stuff to GitHub. You might want to check that out. He's also got some cool animations on there and some other stuff for your display. And don't forget the SPI library as well. Come down here. You want to define your hardware, whether it's the FC16, or you can label it as generic. And we want to define the display size and the output pins right here. And our max devices is 4 for this video. That is the number of MAX7219 chips that's under each matrix, and there's 4 on each of our modules. If you connect 2 modules, you would change that to 8, but we're not doing 2 modules, we're doing 1, so it's 4. And we also define the output pin right here. Then you come down here and you set up your display, the MD Parola display with the SPI connection. Then in the setup, we'll just initialize, set intensity, brightness. Then we'll come down here and then we'll put our message right here, and that will scroll from right to left. So, and you can also change that from left to right here, but it's gonna be harder to read the words if you scroll it that way. And just come down here, that's the loop right here. So the code is pretty short, and thankfully these libraries up here take all the complexity out of using and managing the MAX7219 chip. So very convenient to have these. Here we have text align left, middle, and right, and then inverted, and here's some numbers. So here's the code for what we just saw, and it's much like the code we looked at before. Don't forget your libraries up here at the top, include that. Then come down, you want to include the hardware, and I'm now aware that you can also add generic hardware, Parola hardware, and IC station hardware, which I wasn't aware of before, but that apparently is an option. So I bought mine on Amazon, and there's absolutely no indication that mine is FC16, either on the chip or on the PCB or in the listing on Amazon, but it does work just fine with FC16. The second module that I have absolutely doesn't work at all. I don't know what's up with that. Down here, I'm still using 4 devices. If you're using 2 modules, change that to 8 or however many you're using. I'm sticking with 4. And then down below, don't forget to include your output pin number 3. Then we want to come down here and make sure that our SPI connection is set up. Then down here in the setup, you want to go ahead and set up your display the same as we did before, including the intensity. Set the intensity or the brightness of your display here. Now down here in the loop is where we're going to have a look a little bit different. We're going to set our display with text align to the left, a text align center, text align to the right. And remember, anytime you're typing the text that you want shown on your display, make sure to put that in parentheses. And the next thing we'll see here is inverted text, which instead of the letters being lit up on the display, the letters will be off and the background will be lit up. And finally, we'll print some numbers on our display. And anytime you include numbers, you don't have to put those in parentheses like you do the text. So keep that in mind. I was a little surprised that my second module didn't work. I connected it the exact same way, didn't turn out right. But it might be worth it to pay a little bit more and not get the absolute cheapest that's available on Amazon. So one works fine and one does not. If there are any ideas out there on what's going on, I'd love to hear about it. But I think I'll just try another vendor and buy a couple more of these. They are great fun to play with, and I encourage you to check them out. Well, that's all I've got for you today. I hope the video was useful to you. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you again very soon.